so she asked, because there's a variation in the size of the scroll, top to bottom, how do you account for the variations in the set of lines and so on? So, depending on the place in the world it was originated, in Yemen, they have a different number of lines per column than anywhere else in the world. But the way that the panels were prepared, after they were put together, or after they're prepared, ready for writing, they're all lined. So there's a certain number of lines per column. So they're all marked off evenly. And then after it's scored, then they'll do their best to try and reproduce what they're looking at. But sometimes I run out of room, and we have letters that are condensed, and then sometimes there's extra room left over. Now, to make sure that whoever reads that doesn't think an accident occurred, they'll stretch the letters. So you'll see some letters stretched really wide to take up that extra space. And so, you know, it's not an exact science. There's one in art. In fact, these are all classified as art by the Israeli government. So the way that they are imported and exported is under that sort of a heading. So there's an art involved as well as somewhat of a science. So you try to standardize it as much as possible, but there are still individual characteristics from that particular scribe that you see showing up. Anyone else? Yes?